aromatherapy's gone through a bit of a wave at the moment. You'll notice that everybody's talking about, maybe not the word aromatherapy, but they're certainly talking about the words essential oils. Mm-hmm. So it made me realise that these oils do go in and out of fashion a little bit. Mm-hmm. And what I understood from what people were talking about things out there was that there was a lot of misguided information mm-hmm. or salespeople telling you information about mm-hmm. oils. So it made me really get my skates on about educating people about sure. the everyday uses of essential oil.
Fantastic. So tell me a little bit about what essentials actually are and their typical types of uses.
Well, essential oils are volatile substances. Mm-hmm. They're extracted from plants, either through expression, which mm-hmm. is what we do with our citrus fruits, mm-hmm. or the main and most common method of extraction is a thing called steam distillation.
Okay.
So we put all the plant material into a massive mm-hmm. Container. We have a little bit of water at the bottom, the rack, and then the plant material. The lid goes on and we apply heat. Mm-hmm. Now, when we apply heat to water, we create steam. It is the steam that ruptures the essential oil gland. The steam and oil rises, hits a cold surface and goes via a condensing tube mm-hmm. into a Florentine flask. And you're probably aware when you make salad dressings that you'll have two very distinct liquids sitting there.
Sure.
On the top is the essential oil, which gets bottled. And then the rest of it, it's what we call a floral or a flower water.
Okay.
Mm.
Oh, that's where the rose water comes
yeah.
from in the rose oil. Okay, got it. So, you know, what's interesting about essential oils, you know, you hear things about the chemical vibration or you hear things about frequency or the blood-brain barrier. I mean, what makes them such a unique compound? And
plants are the most phenomenal thing. If we really look into the power of plants, we would not be here without plants.
Mm.
So if we understand from a historical viewpoint, they are part of our food chain, but over history, they've also been part of our medicinal and healing regime. And interesting, modern day medicine has been based on, you know, plant medicine of the past. Sadly, today we look at some of these plant therapies as a little bit woo-woo, where in fact they've been around for thousands of years. And perhaps for people watching this and for people like us, we're now looking at medicine thinking it's a bit woo-woo.
Mm.
So to me, it's about finding a balance. Science is amazing in this day and age. We can replicate smells very cleverly. We can alter and adulterate oils and certain plant extracts. But Mother Nature reigns supreme. She will always outsmart what man can do. So as far as I'm aware and what I'm concerned and what I love mm-hmm. is throughout tradition and throughout the evolution of man and the way we've evolved, I believe it's all thanks to plants.